Have you ever had to give a semen analysis for your fertility evaluation? Well, it can be quite an awkward experience for some people. I'm Dr. Rena Malik, urologist and pelvic surgeon, and today I'm reacting to the Try Guys Test Their Sperm Count. I previously reacted to their video getting a prostate exam, which was so great and really well done, and I'm excited to watch this one as well. If you're new here, I make videos on urologic content, sexual health, bladder health, and much, much more. So if you like what you see, make sure you subscribe and share this channel with your friends. And I want to thank Legacy for sponsoring this video. Let's get to it.
When we talk about fertility, we talk about women having to get tested a lot, but not as much about men. Do you think that's true?
So infertility is defined as the inability to conceive or get pregnant after trying to have a baby for over 12 months. But sometimes infertility specialists will see couples within 6 months if they have other risk factors such as age or have concerns about fertility, because they can start the workup before then. In men, about 20% of infertility is due to male causes, and they do make up another 30% where they also contribute and women contribute. So about half of infertility issues have some male issue as well. But it's very common that women have undergone a full evaluation long before men ever make it to a urologist to get a fertility evaluation themselves. And not to worry, it's actually pretty straightforward for men to undergo a fertility evaluation compared to women.
Every guy is terrified of having a baby, but I feel like secretly we're more terrified of not being able to have a baby.
I'm nervous.
Don't be nervous. It's really easy. You've done this at home 1,000 times.
More than that.
Basically, you're going to collect sperm into a cup.
We were planning on making it a race.
We're going to try and be the quickest.
Go!
Now to think about my wife.
So I'm in the masturbatorium, have to get things ready, and it couldn't be weirder.
Yeah, you just came out, what time was it?
5:07. You're fast at jerking it.
I'll figure out the DVD player, it won't work.
Guys, we did it! 6:54, that's respectable.
How long does it normally take?
Maybe 10 minutes is average.
Okay.
12:25.
I took time to wash my hands after.
I think I'm just gonna use my imaginary.
I hope everyone washed their hands after.
It's actually the slowest.
He's done.
Yeah.
16 minutes.
37 minutes in.
I'm just worried.
Well, I'm done. That was a disaster.
That was not good news. I did it. Bad news is that I missed.
It happened.
It happens.
Not much.
Where did the rest of it go?
I'd rather not say, Eugene.
So, yeah, actually, when you come to an office to give a sperm sample, we'll usually have some paraphernalia for you to use, whether it's a video or magazines. In fact, one of our clinics in our old hospital has some very old magazines that that can be used to help get you in the mood. But yeah, it's really not a ideal situation, because you're trying to do something that's sort of intimate in a sterile environment with white walls and know that someone's waiting for you, especially in this case, they're racing. So that's really stressful in order to produce a sample.
Sperm and semen together are analyzed in something called a semen analysis.
We'll actually take the sample, we'll put it into the machine, and it calibrates, reads the semen, gives us a report.
It's almost fully loaded, which is a choice term.
A little nervous, because actually seeing it in numbers on paper is going to be really eye-opening.
I'm not feeling very optimistic right now.
I just hope that I'm okay. I just hope that I'm normal.
What these guys are getting done is called a semen analysis. And so it's pretty straightforward. You want to avoid having any sort of ejaculation for at least 2 days before giving a sample. And then you give a sample, which is sent to a lab, which is evaluated for a number of factors to check the health of your sperm. What that includes at a baseline is a number of things that are recommended by the World Health Organization, which includes sperm count, the motility or how well the sperm moves, the morphology, the shape of the sperm, and the volume of the ejaculate. And in addition to seeing a fertility specialist and getting a full history where they talk about how many times you've ever fathered children before, potentially if you have other risk factors like having a history of certain exposures, certain illnesses when you were younger, and a number of other things, as well as a physical examination, a semen analysis is required to see the health of the sperm. So giving a semen sample in a doctor's office can be pretty uncomfortable. If you're looking to try and do this from the comfort of your own home, make sure to check out Legacy. They make this process super seamless. You fill out your order form, you get a box in the mail with everything you need. It comes with the specimen cup, the instructions, and the transport media. From the time of collection to the time of analysis takes about 1 week. It's super easy, super straightforward. Anyone can do it. And it costs about the same price as semen analysis in any standard labs, and they give you all the results you need. In addition, they offer cryotherapy where you can store frozen sperm if you need them for a later date.
The sperm like to be about 2 degrees colder than the rest of the body. The heat from a laptop is enough to cook those sperm. Right? So anything that can get in the way of sperm cooling is a bad thing.
I've been wearing boxers all week just perfect. As preparation.
Boxers are great.
Exercise?
Exercise is wonderful.
I'm 0 for 3 on that.
And stress is another big one we didn't allude to yet. Uh-oh. There's a lot of toxins that are bad for sperm. Alcohol. It's okay. Anything in moderation is probably okay. So one of the biggest ways to make your sperm counts go to zero is taking supplemental testosterone. Things that are pretty neutral, caffeine, it makes them motile, right?
Smoking.
Smoking, it's a sign of stress on the sperm, but it's not a deal breaker.
Weed.
We don't really have a lot of data on pot.
Perfect.
Yeah. I think that your sperm are really a good bellwether for how the rest of your body. The quantitative part is how much volume or how much liquid comes out when a man ejaculates.
0.4.
0.4 what?
Milliliter.
That's not much.
It's not.
The highest volume of ejaculate?
It's Ned.
Now, Eugene comes in a close second.
Well, he didn't win, so that's all that matters.
The other quantitative thing is how many sperm come out in that ejaculation. This is how many million per milliliter. Ned and Eugene both are in the 70 million. 3.4 was your volume, times 73.1 gives you a total sperm count of 248.6 million. Eugene, 237.6 million per ejaculate.
We're still competing on a molecular level.
Zach was at 37.9 million. Keith is extremely high concentration at 128.1 million.
What? That's why I don't need all that extra fluid.
He's really only at about 60 million.
Mistakes were made.
Mistakes were definitely made.
But it takes one, right?
I wonder what my boys look like.
So yeah, there's a lot of stuff they talked about in there, and I completely agree with everything. I've talked about a lot of these things in other videos before. I've talked about boxers versus briefs. I've talked about cell phones and your sperm, and I've also talked about all the different things that can affect your sperm production. And so the things I recommend typically to people who may be trying to conceive is don't put your cell phone in your front pocket, put it in your back pocket. Make sure you don't put your laptop on your lap. And you can consider certain supplements to help sperm production. Try to avoid smoking in excess, smoking marijuana in excess, or alcohol in excess. Avoid stress and eat an overall healthy diet with lots of fruits and vegetables. As much as we all enjoy the competition between these guys, this is a spectrum, right? If you had some stressful activity one day, your sperm count might not be as great the next day. In fact, if you're having a infection or you've had the flu, you may have no sperm the next day. So you want to wait a couple weeks before you give a semen sample to make sure that your sperm have time to recover.
We just take out a dropper and put it in a special slide. And we look at it under a microscope.
I bet Keith's sperm are really good at wiggling. Like, oh, Zach is going to have the hairiest sperm.
Eugene's has the kind of sperm that, like, trips other sperm on the way to the egg.
My only hope is that Ned has the strongest, fastest sperm.
Whoa! What? What?
They're pretty cool, right?
Yeah!
The qualitative aspects are the shape of the sperm, which is what we call morphology.
And there's your sperm.
There they are! Look at them!
Oh, look at him go. Look at those little idiots.
That one has two tails right there.
Whoa, you're a freak.
Only 4% of them have to be considered morphologically normal, which means you've got 96% of your sperm are knuckleheads.
Look at those guys.
Knuckleheads.
Wow.
So we'll focus in, but they are doing a dance. The other qualitative thing is how fast they're moving. To get up to an egg, that sperm is running the microscopic equivalent of running from Los Angeles to San Francisco.
Look at those little guys. Oh, they look happy and healthy and fun.
Can we all have kids?
You guys are all armed and dangerous.
Yeah!
That was a super fun episode, and I'm glad that the Try Guys do things like this to help raise awareness and help men go and feel comfortable getting an infertility analysis. Hope you all do if you're struggling, and if not, I hope you enjoyed this episode anyways. Thanks as always, and remember to take care of yourself because you're worth it.